I think this is shortlisted for the Man Booker Prize.
Either hold the cup of coffee or throw it out.
I was just looking at the book.
It's getting the other book all wet.
The napkin.
It's going to spill all over the other books.
Oh, then we have to buy them all. Big wood.
My dad went into a bookstore making the same mistake with his cup of coffee and spilled it all over an encyclopedia of naked statue pictures.
Mm, well, that would explain your parents' coffee table reading selection a little better.
It was $57.
What the fuck?
Plus tax.
All right, I'm putting this out. Outside. This one could be good.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like your mom likes cookbooks. She has so many cookbooks.
She likes to cook.
Oh, Chrissy Teigen's cookbook should work. Should I ask if they have a cookbook?
Say cookbook one more time.
She has this whole chapter on biscuits and gravy. I feel like your mom would be into that.
A chapter?
I read it last week in the New York Times cookbook email blast last week.
A whole chapter?
Oh, I don't know.
Sure, that works.
What you got over there?
A book about sex.
For your mom?
Do you think we have enough sex?
Yes.
How much sex is enough sex?
Can we not say sex so many times in a bookstore?
Sex.
Stop!
Better than cookbook.
Yeah, well, shouldn't we be finding Chrissy Teigen's cookbook?
I was actually really enjoying this book.
Do you think we have enough sex?
Let's find out.
What do you mean?
We turn to page 22 of Sex, Your Boyfriend is the Problem. A handy coitus calculator that tells us if we've been having enough sex based on the length of our relationship, how much time we spend together, and a woman's menstrual cycle.
Okay, well, we've been dating a year.
Mm-hmm.
We spend, like, most of our time together.
I need numbers.
Okay, say, like, 302 days.
Okay, and when was our last period?
Are you pregnant?
Couldn't be if I tried.
Well, how we do?
It's not good, Sam. The diagnosis is bad, really bad.
That's not possible.
Numbers don't lie.
Okay, but who made these numbers?
A reproductive health guru, Susan Bornstein. She has a PhD.
We have lots of sex. We fuck a lot regularly. We bone regularly.
Well, according to Susan, regular sex, a regimen, as she calls it, does not necessarily satisfy the needs of a sexually liberated young woman.
I'm pretty sure I satisfy the needs of my sexually liberated young woman.
First of all, I'm going to let you rephrase that sentence.
Yeah.
Second of all, I would have to disagree.
Okay, on what grounds?
Well, according to Susie...
Oh, so you two are pals now.
According to Susie, we treat sex as a celebration. Sort of like popping a bottle of champagne instead of enjoying a glass of wine.
I don't see what's wrong with that.
Well, Sam, people only drink champagne on New Year's.
Okay, but we have plenty of sex.
Plenty of sex is a phrase that Susie lists on a breakdown of dick defense mechanisms. They are tools boyfriends use to deflect their girlfriend's perfectly reasonable advances.
I do not deflect your advances.
You never want to have sex in the shower.
Your roommates are home.
Even when they're not home.
You know my fingers get pruny.
You want to have sex last night.
I was at work all day. I was tired.
You weren't too tired to watch 2 hours of Planet Earth.
Oh, David Attenborough's voice puts me to sleep.
David Attenborough's voice turns me on.
I'll work on my accent then.
I bought lingerie to my Aunt Carol's 50th birthday and took nudes in the bathroom and you still didn't want me.
We were at a family function.
We left at 10 o'clock.
Yeah, you try getting it up with your girlfriend's father snoring in the next room.
I did try.
Then you know it's very hard.
It wasn't very hard in my hand. You only have sex when you're the instigator.
That is not true.
Not true. And on page 35, Susie said you would say that.
Oh my God.
I'm not saying we have to have sex every day. We just need to let loose, have fun, fuck in public bathrooms, in our friend's bathroom, in our bathroom.
Is this just a bathroom, kid?
No, I just want to have more sex.
It's been been a stressful week. I'm tired.
I've been tired for 3 months.
Well, it doesn't mean I don't want you.
You're certainly not having me.
I'm not gonna do it when I'm tired.
Do it? What, are we 12?
No, we are not 12, but we are in a bookstore.
What? You don't want people to hear us talk about sex in a bookstore?
Stop it.
Shh, shh, really, shh. All you used to do was beg me to be louder.
Well, everyone's looking at us, so.
Good, let them look, let them listen. I don't care, I haven't been fucked in 3 weeks. Last time you touched my boob, it was an accident.
Well, now I'm tired.
All you have to do is just go for it sometimes. I do something silly, you go for it. That's all I ask.
Whatever.
What's that one about?
Wizards.
Ending?
I don't know. I haven't read it.
Does it have a happy ending?
I just said I don't know.
Does it have a happy ending?
Oh.
Yeah.
I mean, it could have
it
a
could.
Happy ending. Mm-hmm. Should I still buy Chrissy Teigen's cookbook?
Yeah. On her way out from the bathroom.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Should you go first?
No, I'm not letting you escape this time.
You're really hot.
Go.
Okay.